Okay, so get yourself ready for your restorative practice. So just have a blanket on top of your usual yoga mat, just to give you a little extra comfort and a little extra warmth. Have a blanket folded nicely for your head. And then have a bolster for your knees and then a couple of blocks. If you feel like you might get cold, then have a blanket where you can reach it. And it's also really nice to have a eye pillow if you have one nearby. So lay yourself on the floor with the bolster underneath your knees and the blanket underneath your head and your neck. So just spend a few moments just getting comfortable. So this is a position we're going to stay in for quite a while. So you'll need to make sure that you're in the right position for your body to relax. If you can cover your eyes, then do, just to quieten the brain and to block out the light. And then just indulge yourself in the pleasure of just laying on the floor. So maybe this is the first time today you have been able to just let go, to relax. So give yourself permission to relax. Give yourself permission to be here and to completely release into the floor. Listen to the sound of your breath. And allow your body to sink into the floor with each exhalation. One of the priorities of this practice is comfort. So if you're not comfortable, don't style it out. Adjust your position until you are comfortable. Take some deep inhalations, filling the lungs from the bottom to the top, and then allowing yourself to release into the floor with the out-breath. soften your jaw by drawing the lower teeth away from the upper teeth. Soften your tongue and your throat to purify your energy. Observe the feeling of skin beneath the feet, drawing your attention to the skin and the flesh and the muscle and the bone of the underside of the foot. And then consciously relax the sole of the foot. So that when you relax the sole of your foot, then the legs become lighter. Draw your attention to the top of the foot, to the skin and the flesh and muscle of the top of the foot. And then relax the top of the foot, just letting the skin and the flesh and the muscle relax, letting the bones relax. Take a deep inhalation and draw your attention into the shins. And then consciously releasing the shin bone into the bed of the calf muscle. Relaxing the shins into the calf muscle, relaxing the kneecaps into the socket, relaxing the muscle and the flesh and the skin of the thighs. Allowing the fronts of the thighs to sink into the backs of the thighs. Draw your attention into the pelvis and the abdomen. And then allow the abdomen to relax. Allow the pelvis to relax. Draw your attention into the chest, into the ribs, into the diaphragm, and then consciously allow the rib cage to soften and relax. Allow the diaphragm to relax. Allow the abdominal muscles to relax. Draw your attention into your arms, into the shoulders and the arms, the upper arms, and the elbow and the forearm, and the wrists and the hands, fingers. goes into the fingernails. And then relax your arms. Let go of the muscles of the arms as though you're unhooking them. And the arms become heavy. Consciously soften the neck. And then we'll draw your attention into the skull, to the skin around the face and around the top of the skull and the back of the skull. Feeling as though the skin is stretching from the top of the head down towards the neck. Soften the muscles of the face, around the eyes and the forehead, around the cheekbones. Release in the inner ear. As we progress into the practice, I'll speak less and less so that you don't need to listen throughout the session. I'll just prompt you with some ideas as we go. But this is about your personal practice.
Just surrendering into the straight line of the floor. Okay, when you're ready to disturb yourself, just wriggle your toes, wriggle your fingers, and then when you're ready, bend your knees and bring the feet onto the bolster. Just rest down on your back for a moment, just feeling how the lower back is supported by the floor in this position. And then very gently roll onto your side and then sit yourself up into a cross leg position. Just hold onto your knees for a moment and just observe your energy. Observe your energy as you just feel the flow of energy. Maybe there's a change in how your energy feels from how we began. Okay, we can do a simple side stretch just to get the shoulders opening up. If you've got one of these oblong bolsters, then this is really good for that. If you haven't got an oblong bolster, if your bolster is a tubular one, it's probably going to be too thick. So what you can do instead is just unfold your mat, so it's folded, your blanket, so it's folded like this, and fold it down the center and then fold that in half, and then you've got a lift that's about the same size as an oblong bolster. So we're just going to have a block for your head, and then maybe if you've got stiff shoulders you might want a block for your hand. So you're just going to come over onto one side and you lengthen the side ribs along the bolster. The bolster is going to go in the armpit chest region, and then rest your head down on the block. Make sure that the shoulder is down on the floor, and then you can either stay with the top arm just resting on the side ribs, or reach over and then bring your arm over your ear and then just
Allow yourself to rest down. If there's stiffness in your shoulders, you can put a block underneath that hand so it doesn't come all the way down to the floor. So just make sure that when you are here, you take deep and even inhalations and exhalations. So while this can feel a little difficult for stiff shoulders initially, hopefully you find how staying in the pose really helps to release the tension from your shoulder. Remember, you should never just bear discomfort. Just adjust the pose with equipment so that you can maintain it without any stress or tension. Spend a little time inside the pose, just allowing the body to release into the floor, letting go of any resistance, consciously driving your out-breath into areas of resistance to help minimize that resistance. Okay, when you're ready, just bring that top arm back to rest on the top of the ribs. And then push your bottom elbow into the floor. And then come up into just cross legs. Just observe how the physical body feels, how the energetic body feels. The energy that you release from these simple, long-held poses. And then just come over onto your other side. So the same pose, just resting on your other side. Have the bolster in your armpit chest. Have the block for your head. Keep the knees bent. And then extend your arm over your ear. And again, just rest into the floor. Use a block underneath that hand if you need to. Otherwise, just allow yourself to release into the floor.
Okay, when you're ready, just bring that top arm to rest on the chest and then push yourself up into cross leg position. Just observe how, again, your energy has changed, how it's lifted around the shoulders and around the neck. The lightness on the inside. Okay, we're going to use our bolster for a bridge pose. So get your blanket, unfold it so that it's a long, long folded blanket like this. So if you did it in half, it would be your kind of just typical folded blanket for your head. And then just roll the end of the blanket up. So you want a reasonably thick roll. And then you're just going to come down onto your back with a roll in your neck and in the in the neck, particularly or around the shoulder region. And then just lift yourself up and then place the bolster underneath your lower back. And then you can either just rest your arms on the sides of the body, or you can stretch your arms over your head. So when, once you come down into the pose, just observe whether the blanket is rolled up enough or if it's too much. Just get comfortable in this supported Setu Banda bridge pose. And then just release your arms either to the side of the body or over your head. Just resting on the floor. So just have your arms either to the side or over the head. You can vary where you put your arms as you stay. So the rolled blanket in your neck should feel as though it supports your neck.
And then just gently bend your knees a little more. Lift yourself, lift the seat bones up off the bolster, and then just rest with the bolster underneath your knees, just lying down directly onto the floor for a moment. And then bend your knees, roll over, and sit yourself up. Just again, just coming up into cross legs, just observe the energy around the neck and the shoulders. Gentle release of energy that the long held poses bring to the body and the mind. And then we're going to finish in the restorative surfboard pose. So have a bolster for your body. Have something up underneath your shins if you've got something spare to put underneath your shins. Otherwise, you can just rest your legs on the floor. Have a block for your head and put a blanket over the top of the block. So you're just going to come down along the front of your bolster, your head resting on the block. Your chin needs to be free of the bolster, and then just let your arms release into the floor, just bending your arms, just stretching your arms away a little, but without any effort. And in no restorative surfboard, just spend some time just breathing into the back chest. And then releasing with the out breath. And then breathe into the center of the back and out into the lower ribs. And then release with an out breath. And then breathe into the bottom of the back and out into the hips. And release with the out breath. So just cycling around the upper back, the middle back, and the lower back. Just continuing to breathe into the back, just allowing the back to expand with the breath, with the in-breath. Just bring the breath back to just a normal rhythm. Just observe how this pose allows you to release in the back and around the shoulders and around the neck. And how the pressure on the forehead helps to bring quietness to the brain. And then when you're ready, just bring your shoulders underneath, your hands underneath your shoulders, and then push yourself up into the seated position, just sitting back on your heels for a moment. Then just observe the energy around the forehead, around the shoulders and the chest. And then just sit yourself on your bolster, come into a cross leg position. And then that was a notification on my computer, so apologies for that. Just come into cross legs with the hands in Namaste, just drawing your breath in through your nose down into your abdomen. Conscious of the energy that you have released through your practice. Good, positive, clean energy that comes from our long-held poses, that lightness of energy that flows around the body. And then draw your chin down to meet your chest. Just spend a moment to seek to acknowledge the positive energy you have created inside. And then send some of that positive energy out into the world. And then gently place the backs of your hands down towards your knees, palms facing upwards,
And as you raise your head, allow your eyes to softly open and focus to softly come back. Thank you. So hopefully you feel as though you've really lifted your energy, giving yourself good energy for the rest of your evening.